Jesus Christ. Put the ball in name. And following in the footsteps of the original apostles. God bless you. And to the saints of this tabernacle, to come and glory, full gospel ministry. God bless you. To the general and the army of the Lord, for the fighting of the war that we have to catch up on, stand firm. For all the saints, we are on the battlefield.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let's don't stop now.
Amen. We have time.
You know, it's amazing how the Lord, how man had the tendency of trying to develop the Word of God into what he wanted.
Yeah. Right, sir, man.
Tim preaches, you know what I mean. And when it comes time to deliver, God said, that's not what I want you to say. My father in Christ, Reverend Scott, was very true in the statement that he made, my God, because I'm an old preacher, an old man. I didn't come from this generation. My mama raised me. And she drugged me to church. Church. I know everybody has a time. chapter, beginning at the 22nd verse. When we find the Word of God in reverence to a worthy God, please stand as we read this word. And I will read the following, please. Are we there? Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Therefore I tell you, don't worry about your life, or what you believe, or about your body, or what you will wear. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothes. Consider the ravens. They do not sow or reap. They have no storeroom for barns, yet God feeds them. And how much more valuable are each and every one of us than the birds? Who of you, by worrying, can add a single hour to his life? Since you cannot do this very little thing, why do you worry about the rest? Consider how the lilies grow. They do not labor a spin. Yet I tell you, not even Solomon in all his splendor was dressed like one of them. For that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today and tomorrow is thrown into the fire. How much more will he clothe you? And you of little faith, and do not set your hearts on what you will eat or drink. Do not worry about it. For the pagan world runs after all such things. And your Father knows that you need them. But seek the kingdom of God first. But seek ye the kingdom first, and all things will be given to you as well. May we pray. Heavenly Father, we have heard your word. Yes. And Father, I'm asking, as I came before your throne of grace, not to allow your word to come back before. Let it meditate in the hearts of your people. Let it irritate them, Lord, so that, Father, they will become uncomfortable. And Lord, let them go out and tell and hear that word to somebody that needs to be heard. Father, I ask you, dear Lord, have mercy on everyone under the sound of my voice. And Lord, have mercy on individuals that are in the hospital. Father, in their room, not able to be here today. Father, we need you more now than we ever did.
Yes, Lord.
Father, the devil is just running rapidly. We are still going back to you. In Jesus' name, Father, I'm praying this church, Lord. I'm praying, Father, for the angel that you have set above this church. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Amen. If I may put a title to this, it's an old Negro song that I think most of us are accustomed to hearing.
Yes.
If it had not been for the Lord on my side, what would I do? My dear brothers and sisters, have we ever taking a moment out of our busy schedule and our lives and just contemplate and meditate on our life and where we have came from.
Amen.
And daydream about where we are going. You know what I mean.
Amen.
Thinking about all the Christ that God has.